So the important thing to know about a clubfoot is that a clubfoot isn't just a foot that's in an abnormal position. It's actually a foot that has been structurally created differently in the womb. And so what that means is that the bones are actually a little bit different than a foot without clubfoot. They tend to be a little bit smaller and shaped a little bit differently. The muscles and tendons can be a little bit smaller and tighter, so a clubfoot tends to not be as flexible as a non-clubfoot. And so oftentimes we can see that the calf is also smaller, as well as the foot being smaller as well. And even the nerves and the vessels can sometimes be a little bit differently formed compared to the other foot or a non-clubfoot. And while we know a lot about the treatment and outcomes about clubfoot, we actually don't know a lot about what causes it. It's probably a bunch of different factors that have led ultimately to a clubfoot, but there's not one specific cause or any sort of specific genetics that are involved. And so what that means is that there's nothing that you or your partner did that led to this foot becoming a clubfoot. So the goal of a clubfoot is not to turn this into a not clubfoot. We accept that this is a clubfoot. It's always going to want to be a clubfoot. But what we do know is that if we can take this foot and get it into a good position where the foot's on the ground and we keep it as flexible as possible, that we're able to get patients up and running and doing all the things that they want to do. And so to achieve that goal, we follow the Ponseti method, which is a series of casts that slowly stretch out the foot and bring it into that position. Often a clubfoot can be diagnosed on prenatal ultrasound, so it might be mentioned to you after one of your ultrasounds, or it's diagnosed pretty soon after birth. What you'll notice is that the foot has this pointed down, turned in position, but it's important to know that this is not painful at all to your baby. We like to start casting at about 1 to 2 weeks of age. So what that means is that there's no rush to do it while the baby is still in the hospital. You can go home, rest, relax, settle into your new life with baby, and then give us a call, and we can oftentimes get you into clinic pretty quickly to start that casting treatment. We are usually able to correct a clubfoot in about 4 to 9 casts. And while casting corrects all aspects of the clubfoot, the one thing it can't correct is the ability to bring the foot up. And so to address this, we usually do a procedure in clinic, so it doesn't require surgery, to cut the heel cord or the Achilles tendon. After we do that, the foot comes up really nicely, and then we can put our final cast on. This cast stays on for 3 weeks, and then you come back, that final cast comes off, and then we start bracing. Bracing is extremely important in the treatment of clubfoot. We know that there's about 100% recurrence in clubfeet that aren't braced. We normally start with bracing for 23 hours a day. So that means that there are a few breaks throughout the day where the braces can come off. You can do tummy time, give baths, do some extra snuggles, and then the braces go back on. Eventually, we do switch to just nighttime or 12-hour bracing as the child gets a little bit older. The transition to bracing can be a little bit tough. As you can imagine, this baby, almost since the time they were born, have been wrapped in these fluffy casts for a long time. The legs haven't been touched or managed, and so the skin can be pretty sensitive to new sensations. And so switching now to bracing, that's a new sensation for them. And so it usually takes a couple weeks for them to fully adjust to these new braces. But it's really important to stay strong during that time. Babies are pretty smart, and they'll learn quickly that if they cry and the braces come off, they're gonna cry every time the braces go on, and it just becomes even more difficult. So it's important to stay strong early on so that we can be successful throughout the baby's early life. So So the goal of the clubfoot is to get it into a good position, keep it as flexible as possible, and we know if we achieve those goals, that child can run, walk, play, do whatever sport or activity or any career they want into adulthood without any difficulty or thinking about their clubfoot. Treatment is not 100% successful, and that's even including families that are great with doing the bracing and being very compliant with that. We know that there's a certain percentage, about 20%, that do require additional treatments or procedures as the child gets older. And again, this relates to the fact that this is a clubfoot and there are some differences in how the muscles have been created, leading to some muscle imbalance sometimes in the foot. And so sometimes that does require additional treatment as the child gets older.